So we have entered Bulu Imam sir's room and we are trying to find some literary work here.
Literary to nahi hai, it is just a work of mine. He has tried before to capture it, but it's not so easy. These are the articles I write, so I just want to show you. This is B290. So, before it will be 289. And these contain my casual writings. I have written about 2,000 important papers. I have published over 500 important papers. 72 in international seminars, so it's a lot of work. This is the last article. The Fertile Crescent of South Ganga Plain. It's an archaeological article about the evolution of the Chalcolithic in southeastern Jharkhand between Ghatshila and Porhat, and how the evolution of the Chalcolithic over there may be connected to the first copper and bronze civilization of Rohtas in Sinuvar. And that is very important because it is the foundation for what I call the South Ganga Crescent, which is the civilization coming from Chirand and Chechar on the Gandak through the confluence of the Son and the Ganga to the civilization of South Jharkhand in North Jharkhand, which is Nalanda, Rajgir, Jamalpur Valley, Kharagpur, Bihar ka baat kar rahe hain. How that is the crescent of the South Ganga Plain, in which the language of resistance began in the middle of the first millennium in Mahavira Jaina and Siddhartha Gautama Buddha. This is the subject of that one essay. Now there are...
So like that there are hundreds of...
I would say hundreds of important articles, let's not say thousands immediately. But that is very important, and I'm conducting in the near future, I hope, a walk in this area because I'm very eager to show that the culture which produced Nalanda and Rajgir and the third millennium civilization of the Chalcolithic and Rohtas and Sinuvar and Tariadi. Culture which became Rajgir, that it actually grew out of a Chalcolithic civilization that evolved from the Paleolithic in southeastern Jharkhand on the Ajay and Sanjay and Suvarnarekha rivers. Now that's a very beautiful connection. That how that culture could evolve, and this is now my new work. So I just showed this because this is just a catalogue of archaeological and literary and ethnographic researches that I have been continuing and I will
continue. You have been doing it since 30 years.
For 30 years I have been doing the same thing. Unfortunately, I haven't yet finished. And so this is now B290. We opened it over here. So this is the article, The Fertile Crescent in the South Ganga Plain, March 2017. And it is... A journey to trace the footprints of the Buddha and Mahavira in Bihar and Jharkhand in the fertile crescent of the Ganga Plain. This word has never been used before outside Mesopotamia. So I like to bring it to Hazaribagh. So this is very interesting work. So you can see that this is just an insight into my academic or post-academic or non-academic, whatever you would like to call it, because I'm not an academic. I don't like academics. I have no time for academics. And I like to be just an ordinary researcher. And this research has been actually set up and much of this covered in my research of Hazaribagh. Jo bolte hain, pura Jharkhand ko chhanna aur ek katori mein lana. This has been done here. And the work, literary, but I don't want to talk of literature when I'm talking of archaeology. So I wanted to open with archaeology and not literature. Literature is not a very well understood subject over here, I think. We have too much literature. So this is the book, Antiquarian Remains of Jharkhand.
Yes, in which year?
2014. This is a publication of INTEC and the Aryan Books International from Delhi. INTEC, Aryan Books International. It is a landmark book now because it documents 1,000 archaeological sites of Jharkhand. You can open it any way you want and let us see where we are. I open on Satgama and Kudarma, which is a very important site. The Ghorsimar Caves is a Buddhist site, so we know the Buddha was there. And the Satpaha Range in the North Karanpura Valley, which I was telling you I was seeing on Google only today, that is in the Upper Damodar Valley. So that particular place that we are talking about in Satpahar, where the Satpohya is in Chatrariva, that is where the rock art is found. So I document 14 rock art sites. This is Notangwa Pahar rock art. So you can see the book is speaking itself.
Exactly.
And so I keep, this is your Jain temple in Khairagarh in the Gola Ramgarh district. So Jainism and ISKCO, this is the ISKCO rock art we are looking at here. How can the Marwatari cave where the Paleolithic remains are found and the Maradar cave which is now so famous, how can these be linked with the rock painting to the development of the paleo-archaeology of Jharkhand and in the context of the tribal traditions, because
have written 4 to 5 books like this.
I've written dozens of books actually, but 4 or 5 maybe of this quality. Yes.
I want you to read one poem.
I think there isn't anything better than just making out a very short poem. I don't want you to have long poems. Because
I'm taking too many long poems. Maybe we could just have songs from Hazariba.
Okay, very good. Hazariba.
It will be too long, actually, to tell you the truth. I want to write you when, read for you when all is gone about Radha, but I don't want to talk of that. We just want to talk of. You saw the poem on Facebook the other day, the Hazari Bagh, the road to Jorhat.
The road to Jorhat.
I suppose you remember that. It was a very evening, beautiful. Well, this is the house I'm standing in, which is called the Grove. Sarna is called a grove. That's the sacred word for Sarna. So this house was called the Grove by my parents who bought it. It was called the Grove. I call it Sanskriti, as you know, because it's Sanskriti. Kriti, you know, it is culture, and Sanskriti is the culture, world culture. So I called it Sanskriti. And this poem I have written as a young boy to the grove. And it hasn't changed. Songs of many little unnamed birds flit muted through the shadowy air. This is the place where I have grown up, and this is where I had little purple sunbirds in my veranda yesterday flying through. And they come and as if they talk to me. So this is very beautiful that I could find a line about the birds. The cool darkened house waits quietly alone and sheltered under the awning of the branches. Still the temperature here is 8 degrees cooler than Hazari Bagh town at any time. When you come into my house it will be cool. Even in the summer I don't need an air conditioner. Because I am living almost jhor mein reh rahe hain. So this very beautifully in poetry sums up the atmosphere of what Hazari Bagh is to me. It is the birds, it is the cool air, it is the clean air of being in, among the leaves. Na? Poetry is more than words. Poetry is a state of mind. And so here we have a state of mind. Otherwise I can open books and read big poems to you. But I don't think that's what I want to do. Look, I have written over here, 100 years from now when memory returns, others' eyes, perhaps of my own family, will look upon this scene of unspoilt loveliness and know my vision and find that thing. I hope so. Yes. When I am gone, every poet would like that somebody would one day return. I went to my great-grandfather, Nawab Imdad Imam Sahib, who was a very famous poet, Persian poet, lived in Abgila in Gaya. And when I went to his house, half a century after he died, and I went to his grave, and when I heard the birds in his trees, I suddenly remembered he was my great-grandfather. Mm. And I heard the song of birds in his garden, and I went to his fish pond, and I thought that he would have been happy that I went. Mm. So I think the greatest thing a poet can hope is that whatever he writes and leaves, rather than there being very big intellectual tomes, mm. that they should be of consequence to his grandchildren or great-grandchildren when they return, and they say, Dadabba ye likhe the, Nanabba ye likhe the. And that is the greatness of a poet, that he's never forgotten.
Exactly.
That is why we do not forget Ghalib, and we do not forget Kalidas, we do not forget the poets who left things that we find so common even today.
Thank you so much.
Not at all. I didn't want to impress you with my achievements.
For your literary.
I just simply wanted to work, share my life.
We are trying to decipher many things.
I know you want to show the big thing I am.
Exactly.
But the problem is that an elephant always tries to hide himself, not to show himself.
Exactly.
Because he's embarrassed by his size. So I am also like that. I feel embarrassed by the quantum of work I have done.
So you can see the room where he
lives. Yeah, this is my, I call it Garib Khana.
But exactly, this has got very valuable things in it, sir.
Yes, because these paintings that I have hanging over there, now that you mention it, I had forgotten. But my son reminded me the other day
that
he was showing somebody these paintings, and he said, my father kept these paintings because they are the paintings of his first book on the art,
okay.
35 years ago. And he keeps these paintings as his special treasure. So these are my special paintings that were published in a very old book which is being reprinted now in Europe. So for me, these little things mean more than the
that
hanging in a big museum. Because the real things are the small things. Yeah? Well, these are just a glimpse of unpublished manuscripts. I have about 30 books pending publication over here. So perhaps you could get an idea by just looking at this. These are all unpublished manuscripts waiting for publication.
Now we have got a very special museum also, which sir is preserving since 30 years, and we will see what Sanskriti offers.
You will, no doubt about it. The second volume of my book, Antiquarian Remains. So you can see this is exactly how I write. That's how I write. So Dilip Chakravarti's Archaeology of Eastern India. This is the Prehistoric Archaeology of Bihar by Vasudev Narayan. So this is Archaeology of Rohtas District by Dr. Pandey. This is Dr. Pradhan's Rock Art in India. And so this is how I put my work together.
Before going further, we want to have a look at your study room, the small study room, which is the unique
thing. Certainly. I just come back from Ceylon. So you see Jain Seminar in Ceylon. So you will see that I have got some papers here that are pertaining to that. Because you know, you like to always know that who is this person, so you will find my name over here, my full name. This is the Jain Digambar Mahasabha, Bhartiya Varsha Jain Digambar Mahasabha. And I just come back from Buddhism and Jainism in early historic Asia. I gave a set of photographs on Facebook. So this is just a quick insight into a very privileged life. Certainly it's been a very privileged life for me, because I have received, like you are giving me the opportunity to show my work many places. I have received that opportunity. And obviously a man has done a lot of work in 70 years, so I don't want to impress you with individual pieces because it will become too much.
Exactly. Yes.
So I want to keep that as out of the picture as possible. I have a feeling that
I have not kept something. Oh, here. Sorry. Now, for Facebook readers, I think a very interesting thing is that somebody asked me to do a book, so I have got this. This is Jharkhand. This is Facebook comments.
Okay.
You know, I write on Facebook.
Yes.
So I have got a separate file with about 500 or 600 articles on Facebook. I write regularly on Facebook, no?
Yes.
So maybe I thought for Hazaribagh, this is my grandfather, Sayyid Hasan Imam, who was president of the Indian National Congress in 1918. My granduncle Sir Ali Imam was the founder of modern Bihar in 1911, with Mazharul Haq and Sachitran Sinha. So coming from an old family, with these Facebook comments, maybe I can make a little book for Hazaribagh Facebook friends.
Sir, yes, sir.
This is my hope. I have it here. So like that, to show you, too many files will be of no use. Because as you can see, there are 100, 300 multiplied by 30, there are about over 2,000 papers to look at, so it's too much. I keep a daily diary. I write everything I do. I'm very conscientious. I have maintained diaries for 75 years. So I have my whole diary of Hazaribagh. It's properly in chronological order. So after I die, the people of Hazaribagh can have one library of my diary. So at any point of time, they can know what happened in Hazaribagh between my birth and my death.
Exactly.
That's another gift I have given. So I hope you like what you saw.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to do a few things. I'm on the internet. At least 3 hours every day I spend studying, looking at things on the internet. So this, my daughter, my grandson, and
Sir, at this age, how do you manage? I mean, 3 hours in internet and...
No, work is like sleep. It doesn't make any problem. There's no difficulty. This is Valcomunica, so this is very important, I think. Give me my glasses, Vikram. I'll just show you what I'm doing. This is very important because you can see here the academic part of it. Hello, Gustav. The academic part of it. Animals in the rock art of Hazaribagh. You know, Gustav, I'm of the view that we should put the animals over here. Because I'm finding in this particular paper, each of the animals should be illustrated. It's a 20-page paper, so it's a very long paper. Better make it into a book. Maybe you could show...
It's a slide presentation on the animals.
Is it a slide presentation on the animals? Well, maybe we could make the animals into illustrations. Because we have already given about 30 animals. I've just been through it and seen. It starts with trilobites and cells and crabs and goes on to tiger and wild boar and fish and 40 different types of animals in the rock art of Hazaribagh. So that's an important documentation. I took out this paper because I see 5 papers over here from the UNESCO conference in Valcomunica. Comparative traditions in village painting and prehistoric rock art of Jharkhand. Valcomunica Symposium 2011. This is in Italy, in the Italian Dolomites. There's a very beautiful rock art center called the Valcomunica Center. And Valcomunica is a famous area for rock art. And Professor Emmanuel Anati has conferences every year. And for the last several years, I have been giving papers in every conference in the rock art over there. As you can see, contemporary Tana Bhagat Puja to a massive Chalcolithic rock art site at Thangi in Chatra district. This is where the Tana Bhagats do the puja. And you can see that this is a documentation of rock art in the context of the Tana Bhagat Puja. Now this particular paper is not mine, it's by my son Justin, but it's been presented at the same conference in Valcomunica. Since we were looking at it, I thought I might as well look at some academic work. The historical perspective of prehistory through a study of Mesochalcolithic rock art and contemporary tribal mural paintings in Jharkhand in eastern India. That's a rather important thing to know, that a man in Hazaribagh is doing this sort of work. Understanding rock art in the environmental context and in relation to territory. I believe this was the paper that I gave in Burgos in Spain. So, I mean, these are all important parts of Hazaribagh and the academic.
Unfortunately, the University of Hazaribagh never sees all this work because I don't share this. This is my own work. So this is academic work that you're looking at here. I'm just taking you through several papers. I'm just trying to find some papers of the IGNC conference recently they had on India and China. I had a paper in that. And here is Animals in the Rock Art of North Jharkhand, which we have just seen. And so I think that this is giving you a very good idea of the type of work that I am doing academically, so I can put it on the computer. We should see one more thing over here. I talked to Sri Lanka, which is important to me at the moment. I've just come back from there. By the way, this is Gustav's PhD in University of East Anglia. I think this one. Gustav? Which is the... I think that we can... No, MA dissertation. I've got it. Okay, I'm not opening it. Well, I'll open it if you say yes, if you know where it is. Yeah. Connecting Anthropology and Museums. Mutual influence of Cambridge and Chopinacqua in late colonial period. This is extremely important because I hope that my son Gustav will go on to do his PhD in Oslo University, as we are hoping. I had hoped it would be Cambridge, but Cambridge wanted an MA from Cambridge. Okay. And Connecting Anthropology and Museums, Mutual Influence of Cambridge and Chotanagpur in Late Colonial Period, which is Sarachandra Roy's work in the late colonial period, Edward Gates' work in the same time, Bodding's work in Santhal Parganas, and my work in Hazaribagh, and also work by P.R. Sarkar and Sarachandra Roy. These archaeological connections have been dealt with in his MA dissertation. So if he can bring back anthology and museums between England and Jharkhand, so then this museum which I'm making in Hazaribagh would be a very important connection. He's dedicated it to his mother. My wife, his mother, is an Urang tribal. Okay. And so you can see that we have got the right material for a Jharkhand connection with England. So he says here the dissertation focuses on the Edward Gates collection along with Sarachandra Roy's photographic and stone tool. It will be stone tool collection. So I won't take up more of your time. I think we have been able to see something over here from the academic point of view.
Yes, sir.
Without opening up books or poetry,
exactly.
It will take time and editing. Because I suggested to you that this should be more a swift, brief glimpse into something. Because if you want to understand the world, unless you're going to make years of planning to do it, you can't do it properly. It's much better to go and just get a brief glimpse into it so that the viewer will say, yes, there is something. And the way to find it is what I did with you. I opened a file here, a file there, a file. By accident, I told you. I opened these. I didn't plan anything.
Yeah.
So you saw that, yes, it is here. Because if you go in Aladdin cave, you will find a few objects. Isn't it so? So it is now evident to the viewer of the film that yahan par koi cheez hai, hai na? That is necessary. Otherwise, if you try to impress the viewer, he would try to say that, oh, bahut apna ghamand kar raha hai, apna dikha raha hai, na? You don't want academics especially will be critical. What does he think? Who PhD kiya hai, uska certificate lao, ye sab ka baat hai. But I don't want to enter into that. Hum jo bhi kiye hai, very simply, I'm showing it to you. Aapko achha laga to theek hai, nahi laga. तो देखने वाला तभी पसंद करेगा।
We are entering the reading room of Bulu Imam sir. Alex, you have gotten it.
This is a little reading room where I spend my time reading. It's a great place to read, I can tell you, because I've got all my favorite books here. I can Queen Victoria. Where is the other one? I'm reading this with this. Nicholas and Alexander. Before the assassination. This is the most beautiful family ever produced in Russia. Nicholas and Alexander. Tsar Nicholas and his wife Alexander and their five girls and boys and Queen Victoria.
So how much time do you spend here every day?
Not much. This is Kipling's Kim. So you can see some of the books. There are 30 books on global warming over here. I have got all books on India flora and fauna in these cupboards. This is the fauna of British India here. Don't worry about it. You can see that.
I have 13 years among the wild beasts of India. That's Sanderson, the fauna. I have more books inside only dealing with the wildlife.
Okay.
I'm very interested in wildlife. Cultural heritage of India, Indian painting. These shelves will show you a view on my books. So I spend very happy hours over here when I can read undisturbed, because I don't find that disturbing me. I don't like to be disturbed when I'm reading. So this is I have everything next to me, all my books next to me. I have got about 1,000 books there that I can read without anyone disturbing me. I say 1,000, maybe 2,000, I don't know. So I enjoy reading already. It's a quiet room, nobody disturbing me. And then I have this big study, I have my computer, I have my bedroom, I have my own museum.
Yeah.
So I don't think I need much now.
Yes,
sir. Now I need a little equipment for documentation. God willing, we put the museum together. But we can go to the museum.
Okay.